My name is Julius Heitkoetter. I've been working along with Tim Kraska and Christoph Paus to design AI augmented support for computing services, and this is kind of what we've done so far. And so first, kind of like why we would even care about something like this, as I'm sure all of you guys are aware, these days computing is very relevant in physics. And that's great. We have a ton of computation power in our hands. We get to process large data sets. It works great. However, it requires use of programs that require very specific knowledge that is often just like syntax or something annoying to learn. Current solutions are giant help repositories or just help desks, which are tedious to manage and slow to interact with. However, recently, large language models have grown to become viable tools for assisting us with these kinds of things. And so this is why we thought it might be important to explore. However, just using straight up out of the box ChatGPT has some significant downfalls. For example, it does not know the specifics of your computing system. It might think you have something installed when you don't. It feels it must create an answer. We've seen a lot of cases where it kind of hallucinates something that isn't quite true. And just gives you a wrong answer. It can only offer text support, right? So a lot of these are just basically text to text, when in reality we're interacting with a more complex system, a full-on computer. And to follow on that, it just fully can't interact with the computer, so it can't do things for you, can't help you out with things, that you're just talking to a text robot. So using an out-of-the-box GPT is not an option. Creating a custom one, unfortunately, is very expensive. GPT-4 costs around $100 million to train. You can see here, as the models become more reliable and more feasible to use, they also are becoming more expensive. And so we need some other way to solve this, and that way is chaining. And so many of these concepts you've actually seen earlier today, but I just briefly want to go over a very simple chain, which is takes as input some chat history of the thread I've been having with the chatbot, and then the actual question. And as well as some input files that are giving us some sort of context to what is actually being used when I'm talking, like what is actually being used in terms of the computer and it's what it has installed and whatnot. And so I embed the input files and I put them into a vector database, which I use a semantic search query based off the chat history and the user question to get some context. I put that into a clever prompt that I've used some prompt engineering to put together, and then I output just a simple plain text LLL input. I feed that through a large language model, and then I get some sort of output. And so this is a really simple chain, but enough about theory, more to an actual application. For those of you who don't know, Submit is a centralized computing resource which is available to the entire physics department. Users are able to easily submit jobs to bigger computation services or also work on Submit directly. Submit has many powerful parts of it. You have over 1 terabyte of scratch space. You have many, many GPU and CPU servers. So for anybody who wants to experiment around with their own large language model or AI applications, this is kind of a great scratch space to work. And it has a lot of cool tools on it. It has Jupyter Hub to work directly with it, or you can submit batch jobs through Slurm or HT Condor. And one of my favorite parts about Submit is it emphasizes on helping users figure out how to use it. It has a very active help desk, and it has a lot of resources that are just out there for you to learn how to use it. And here's some nice resources so you see the Submit website. You see there's a well-written and large user's guide. There's many examples on how to do some specific things, like this is a Slurm script. And then, like I said, there's this help desk. And we can actually use these resources as input to a chain, as these input files, to create an AI which knows the ins and outs of Submit and can help the users of Submit navigate it. And so here's a really basic example. Chain that we could use is I could ask something about, you know, I want to submit 100 GPU jobs, and we just look through the vector store, and we find that there is a page on the user's guide that talks about Slurm, and that helps with submitting batch jobs. Slurm is a program, for those of you who don't know, that submits batch jobs and would do something like this. And then there's also an example. And then you give it this prompt. This is a very naive prompt, but you could think of more contrived ones. And then you actually get very, very good answers out of it. But you can take this chaining even further, actually, and create something which is not just a chatbot that you're interacting with, but an actual identity that's helping you with your computing needs. And so that's where we developed Archie, the AI augmented research chat intelligence. And Archie is an actual member of the Submit help team. Just like many other people of this help team, she can write emails to you. You can Slack her. You can have her help with help desk questions. She can manage the help desk and help with that, and then do much more. So we can use this training to not just have a text bot, but an actual entity that we get to interact with. And so this is kind of our first prototype, is Archie. It's powered by LangChain, which is what we use for chaining, Gradio for the user interface, and Chroma for vector database. It is actually currently live. You can go to that URL and you can play with it. Or you can just go to submit.mit.edu and you'll see there's a page for Archie. If we all use it all at once, there may be a little bit of lag, but it should be fine. And it's also fully open source, so anybody who wants to look at how we do it can look. And as you see here on the right, is actually a member of our project team and a full entity in our project team. So the actual goals of Submit, of Archie, is to become seamlessly integrated as a member of the collaboration of people that is used in the physics department to manage this computing resource, Submit. And to do that, it should be nicely and guardrailed so that we can trust that its answers are not just correct, but also relevant. It should perform actions to Submit to help them. For example, check their quotas for them or something like that. And it should be well integrated into Submit so that it knows the ins and outs of Submit and knows what to do. And what's also exciting is it's an AI, so it gets to self-improve. So as you talk to it, your responses are, you can like or dislike your responses, and eventually we actually get to use this to fine-tune the network. And so as Archie continues growing and we continue using it, it will continue getting better. Here's a cool demo. So you can ask it, the GPU question, and you can see here, it tells you a little bit about Slurm. And it actually also, we tell it to cite its sources. So it can cite the Slurm docs, it cites the click here to read more is an actual web page on the user's guide that it reads to. And so we can double check that its answers are based on our fact. And you can see that actually wasn't very specific on what actually this javascript.sh should be, so I just asked a follow-up question. And it gives you something, and it turns out it actually works. If you were to do this on your computer, you would, in fact, run 100 GPU jobs, which did run.py. Maybe run.py is, I don't know, some cool neural network that you built that you wanted to try out. We also have some nice guardrailing. For example, if you're trying to use Submit to illegally download movies, it won't let you, or it won't tell you how. And moreover than that, we've developed, past the chatbot, we've developed as user, as the help desk integration. So conversations with Archie are actually tickets in our help desk system, Clio, and Archie is an actual user of this help desk. So when you send an email to the help desk, it could get assigned to Archie, and then Archie produces an initial answer. Now the big difference between Archie and our other users is Archie doesn't just send the answer back, it actually has to be curated and double-checked by a human. So an example of this is an email that got sent to Submit, and just asking about the data quotas and 50 gigabytes of data. And you can see Archie takes it and marks it from new to in progress, and then actually goes through and answers what it thinks is the correct response. And then a user, a help desk admin, can go through and see, oh yeah, this is actually true, and then mark it from in progress to feedback. Upon which Archie will pick it up again and send out the response it sent and change it from feedback to resolved. And the question has been finished unless the user replies again, which Archie can pick it up again. We're also exploring many future features of Archie. For example, for it to actually be able to interact with Submit. So let's say you're using wget to download a file via command prompt and you're getting some weird errors. That you just don't have any idea. This actually happened to me 2 weeks ago. And it would be nice if Archie could then interact, do a very simple du.sh, and realize that you've actually filled up your home directory, and this is why it doesn't work. And we're very hopeful that in this, and then of course we would allow Archie as a user on to Submit, and then of course with some sort of small set of commands that it can run, which are basically just focused on monitoring, so it can use Submit to help answer users. So as a quick conclusion, we have a nice proof of concept that shows we can successfully use chaining to have this large language model fit our specific task that we need. The integration of custom-built AIs into things like help desks, Slacks, and things like that makes the augmentation between the augmentation of the users seamless and convenient. And upcoming developments to allow AIs to directly interact with computing resources will make it so that Archie basically is and acts just the same as any other person we have working at our help desk. And so we're welcoming Archie to part of the team, and much more is coming soon. Thank you. Any questions?
Thank you. We're still behind, but maybe time for one question.
We have a question from the Zoom. So Noah Chartoff said, sorry if I missed this, but you mentioned that we could get not just a chatbot, but an actual entity to interact with. I'm not sure I understand the distinction between the two.
Ah, yes. So the idea is a chatbot is some website that you log onto, and then you just have a chat interaction like this. But we want to put an emphasis on Archie being an entity, which means that we want it to do more than just chat via a chatbot. We want it to actually be part of our help desk. We want it to be a user on Submit that can do things on Submit. We want it to be able to work into Slack and have us be able to integrate into Slack and ask it questions into Slack. And so when we're talking about being an entity, we're talking about applying Archie in ways so that our users basically just get their experience augmented instead of having to separately just go to a chatbot like ChatGPT and do it from there.